Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making cheeseburger sloppy joes. So it's going to be sloppy joes. That means it's going to be runny and gooey, but it's going to have the flavor of a cheeseburger. So you're going to expect some hamburger and some cheese somewhere. But also there'll be some flavorings that are common to sloppy joes. We're starting with 1 pound of ground beef, and we'll be browning that. We're going to brown that along with a small onion, chopped, and one green bell pepper, chopped. I'm going to add some salt. Just whatever you think is right for you, and some pepper, and you can always taste this at the end and see if you want to add more. So I always go light on it at the beginning. We're going to take this over to the stove, and I need to put it over medium heat at the beginning and then turn it down to low and stir continually while this ground beef is browning. And if there is grease that comes up in the bottom, I will drain that off before I come back. We have the ground beef browned along with the green pepper and chopped onion. And I did remove the grease that collected at the bottom, and I have that much that I'm discarding. This is not part of the recipe. Once you have the beef browned, you're going to add in a couple of ingredients. Here we have 1/4 cup of steak sauce. You may use any brand you like. This happens to be A1 steak sauce. So something like that will turn out very well. And then you want 1 cup of beef broth. Again, this can be any brand that is canned or boxed, or if you make your own, if you have roast beef or something and you want to make some beef broth, then 1 cup is what we need here. Then we're going back to the stove and just cook this down until you could imagine having it on a sandwich bun, because these are going to be sloppy joes. Here we have our sloppy joes cooking at the stove, and you just need to stir them occasionally. You don't have to do it continuously. And at about this point where it's beginning to cook down and be a little thicker, I'm going to take a taste, and I just need to go for some of that sauce. And I'm really wanting to know, does it have enough salt and is the pepper right? Tastes good, and actually it has plenty of salt. I think the broth that we put in was salty, and that's enough salt for me. But you want to stop and taste about this point, and then we'll let it cook down just a little more. When your sloppy joes are cooked down, they will look like this. There's not much liquid. However, when you serve them, it's a good idea to use a slotted spoon. And if there is any excess liquid, it will go through the holes in the spoon instead of absorbing into your bread. You may use any kind of hamburger bun that you like. I tried to pick out something a little different, so I chose these bolillo rolls. They are large, so either cut them in half after they have been filled, or serve them as is for people with large appetites. So what I'm going to do is open this one, then use provolone cheese, and if you like that a lot, put one on each half of the bun. And then you're going to put your mixture in the middle, and it will cause the cheese to melt. I think I'll just put it all on this one side. And if you want to put some of that sauce in, as long as you don't go overboard, it's really tasty. But that's one reason to cook it to the point where it's mostly absorbed, because all of that good flavor goes into this meat sauce. So now we're going to put the cap on and let it sit for just a little bit before we take a bite of it, because we want that cheese to melt some in order to taste the cheese of the Cheeseburger Sloppy Joe. I'm getting ready to take a taste of this, but it is a large sandwich for me, so I'm going to go to the center and just use a steak knife and cut through here, and that will give you a better view of what's inside anyway. You can see the bread is pretty thick, so you may want to put a lot of filling in and make sure you have enough cheese to satisfy you. And let's see how this tastes. Ooh, it looks really yummy. I love having melted cheese with a sandwich like this. So you can just let it sit long enough to do that. If you want to, you can heat it and that will melt the cheese. I'll go over here to the corner. It is dripping a little bit, so it is sloppy. It tastes wonderful. It's the best part of two dishes. Cheeseburgers, which I love, and Sloppy Joes, which I love. So I knew I couldn't go wrong with this, and I picked it as something that you might want to make for a Super Bowl get together. It's a little sloppy, but if you have some kind of a little saucer or plate or a paper plate or something like that, it's not that bad. And you can actually control that a little more. You can cook it down until it just does not drip at all. But I think you and any of your guests will really enjoy this. People generally like to try something new, and people who are entertaining usually like something new, but they need it to be easy and quick and fun, and this is. I think you will love it.